again, you are most welcome to quick, easy and simple way of making day-to-day sabzi curry session, which is specially ongoing on July month by crazyforveggie.com. Now you know what, lentils are very important part, especially if you are a vegetarian, because we have to balance the protein and the portion of the vegetables into a day-to-day life. So sometimes you know you can make a sabji out of lentil soup. That's what I'm making today. Today I'm making a moong dal sabji. Now you know what, you can make a moong dal sabji with two types. You can use a skinless moong dal, which what I'm going to use today, or you can use a regular moong dal which has a skin. You can soak it overnight and you can, you know, get rid of the skin by water. And that is a really healthy way, because that moong dal has a high protein. But you know, it's a long time to do that, so that's why it's easy to use a skinless moong dal. So I'm using this, but they actually take a long time to cook, so that's a drawback of, you know, skinless moong dal. So now let's see how to make our moong dal sabji. Now this sabji is so amazing with amras and roti. So let's see how to make this. Here I have a pan, and into that I'm going to add oil into it. So add oil. So let's wait until our oil getting hot. So, and this is our moong dal. I soaked it for like 5 hours in enough plenty of water. So it's like that, it will be like that. And the dry moong dal will look like that. I want to show you like that, okay. Okay, so our oil is hot. So into that I'm going to add asafoetida. That's a hing. And 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and into that now it's time to add our moong dal. So I'm going to add it. Okay, now if you wish, you can you know, this is this measurement is for 1/4 of dal, but you can make it more. And one more thing, you can, I just kept that water in which I soaked the moong dal, so later on I am going to use it for cooking our moong dal. And further that also we will need some water, and add salt into it. Okay, so now again mix it and cover your pan and cook it for next 1 minute like that only, without adding water. And right now, you know, keep your flame on a low. So it's been a 1 minute, so now I'm going to add water into it. So this is the water in which I soaked my moong dal. So I'm going to add it right now, and I don't think that I need to, you know, add more water at this point. So now mix it well, and now keep your flame on a medium, and cover your pan and cook the moong dal until it's properly cooked and mushy. Now you know, if you are using a skinless moong dal, you know, it takes long time to cook compared to the like the moong dal which already has a skin, and you remove it and then after you make a sabzi out of it. So timing, so the cooking time will be different if you are making the same sabji with a different moong dal which has a skin. So now I'm going to cover this, and you know, keep your flame again on a medium and let it cook. It's been like 15 minutes, and you can see that, you know, I keep my lid little bit on open on this side, so you know, by that it will like air from inside will able to go outside. And so that's why, you know, your moong dal will not ruin your gas stove. So now into that I'm going to add cumin and coriander powder, 1 teaspoon, and a little less than 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, and just a pinch of garam masala. And now into that I'm going to add my crushed garlic. So I'm adding this. Now if you want to fasten up the process, you can also cook this into pressure cooker, okay. And or you can use the moong dal which has a skin, so you just have to take care of, you know, taking out that skin. So now for the final touch, I'm going to cover this, and I'm going to cook this for next 2 minutes. And one more thing, that you do not have to stir it while it was, you know, cooking for that 15 minutes, otherwise it will stick into bottom. So that's a good point, you know, this is not a super quick recipe, but yeah, this is easy because you don't have to do anything. You just have to let this dal cook by itself on a stove, and you just have to add the rest of the spices. So yeah, now final 2 minutes and our dal will be done then. So it's been a 2 minutes now, and our sabzi of moong dal is ready. Now it's properly cooked. Now if you want to make more dry, add less water, but I do not like that sabzi to be little more dry, otherwise it's really feel dry with roti, so I always keep this much moisture. So yeah, that's it. Now you can just garnish it with adding some cilantro and your moong dal sabzi is ready. Hey friends, so that's it for my today's session. That was a recipe of a moong dal sabzi. I hope that you like me this recipe. Please like me this recipe and do subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will see you soon with lot many recipe. Till then, take care. Goodbye.